What's up, everybody? Clint here with Classic Firearms, coming at you guys today with some roller delayed goodness here. I've got MP5 clones, PTR Zenith, got a PTR 91, C308, Setmes. It's gonna be an exciting day here at Take Aim Training in Range. So guys, first off, this video is all about what is roller delayed blowback. First off, it's an absolute obsolete system. We don't need it anymore, and that's a joke. Anyway, I wanted to go ahead and show you guys what exactly this is. And before we even go here, go ahead and leave a like if you used to think that a roller lock was because this rolled and locked into place. Just let me know down in the comments, and also leave a like. Anyway, no, roller delayed blowback, roller lock, two different things, but what we've got today are roller delayed blowback systems. And what's actually rolling are these little guys right here, rollers. How about that? Now, what you'll see is whenever the bolt is actually all the way back here into the carrier, these are sticking out, and you'll notice when I squeeze them, it will move forward ever so slightly. So these are very similar. The system in general is very similar to the direct blowback system. These aren't gas operated. It's actually just operating from the pressure built up behind the cartridge. And the difference between a direct blowback versus a roller delayed blowback is the direct blowback, like what you see in the CZ Scorpion, all that pressure that's built up, it's not really waiting for safe levels of pressure to disengage these rollers to push the system back. And then for the recoil operation to take place, see this here, coming forward and then picking up that next round and chambering, right? And then these will lock into place on the barrel trunnion. Easy enough, cool, right? Okay, so the direct blowback system, like I said, and that you find in the CZ Scorpion, doesn't have, I guess you could say, that safety net. Pretty much what it has is any pressure that's built up, it's going to start cycling. The advantages over the direct blowback system for the delayed blowback is that, first off, these are typically a lighter felt recoil because, like I said, it only disengages after safe levels of pressure are felt, and then it will do a softer cycle of operation. They're going to be lighter in the bolt area, so that of course means less felt recoil as well. And if using while suppressed, you'll notice that these will actuate a little bit better than a direct blowback system because you don't have just any type of pressure cycling the bolt. It's going to be that safe level of pressure that disengages the rollers and then allows the bolt to cycle. Pretty cool stuff. So I just wanted to show you guys that right there and how that functions on an MP5 clone, pretty much. Now, things are pretty similar into the bigger guns like we have with the PTR C308. However, when it comes to suppression, things like that, and pressures, you start to see the advantages of the roller delayed blowback system, not as effective here, but still extremely reliable, going to cycle no matter what designs. So just wanted to throw that out there. And of course, if you guys have anything to add to that, just let me know down in the comments. Now, I guess you could say benefits of the gas blowback, or excuse me, I keep saying gas, that's not correct. The direct blowback system is the fact that it's one, cheaper, a little bit simpler, and not as many complicated parts, pretty much, right? So affordability and cheaper and still a very reliable system until you start suppressing and things. But I've had my CZ Scorpion that I just run suppressed all the time give me like no issues. So I don't know, you guys let me know down in the comments. But anyway, roller delayed blowback, that's what we're going to be talking about now. Really cool system. Really like how it works, and it's just a smooth operation all around. So you can see in this PTR that we've already got locked open. You can see this bolt, which goes in like that right there, right here. So this locks into place by turning the handle. You do that beautiful HK slap, that locks into place, and now you've got the bolt that has picked up the round, chambered it, and now you're ready to start rocking and rolling. In fact, let's go ahead and shoot this guy a little bit. Got one of the ETS mags that it comes with loaded up here. And let's just see, since this guy is the PTR, this is the PTR 9K, so it is the nice shorty compact one. It does come with a single point bungee sling, which is really cool because you can tighten that on your body and you can get this thing to hang, you know, pretty high up. And then whenever you go to shoot, you don't have to worry about a brace or anything. You just pull that against your body and now it's tight against your body, and it'll help you also manage that recoil as well. But you'll see here right now that recoil isn't something that we're all that concerned with this guy. So you'll notice a little bit of muzzle rise. If we were to compare this to a direct blowback system, you'd notice probably a little bit more muzzle rise, things like that. But again, just watch. Super easy system to control. Also a nice feature is the fact that the charging handles are non-reciprocating. Granted, how small this port is here for it, you don't really have to worry about getting it in the way too much, but you'd be a little concerned. Let's go ahead and empty that mag out really quick. All right, boom, lock that open, go for your mag change, and then slap it back, right? Pretty cool stuff. So the PTR 9mm here, again, the K model, guys, is a heck of a lot of fun, all right? Now, like I said, the roller delayed actions on these guys, yeah, they're gonna be a little bit more expensive for what they are, but they're super reliable, they're fun shooting, clean shooting, and they just work really, really well. And they've been around for a long time too. The MP5 is probably only like one of the most popular SMG platforms ever. Nope, the MP5 is just the best, all right? So if you've got a, concern with that or a disagreement, let me know down in the comments, but you're wrong. Anyway, let's move on to the bigger guys here. So what we've got is my PTR-91 here, and this guy along with the C308, which also has this beautiful wood furniture on it. Also too, I just want to show you this neat little feature that you get with the C308. With your FN SCAR, you get a tactical UGG boot. The C308, you get a tactical oh my god face. Just wanted to throw that out there, all right? Anyway, let's go ahead and actually something, let's talk about this really quick. The PTR-91 is probably a great clone based off of the G3 design. H&K, well, the G3 was designed after the Setme design. The C308 has a very much so Setme design to it, or I guess you could say historical features. However, they pretty much took this design, the same German engineers pretty much went to HK or started HK and made the G3, which has also been very loved by all you HK guys out there. But you'll notice some features on this guy, well, not on this guy, but are on here. For instance, a little bit better enhanced charging handles over a period of time. The ones that this one comes with isn't bad, but the originals weren't all that great. Also too, this does not feature like a paddle mag release. It is just a mag release right up here. And so for me, that's a little bit of a stretch, but again, not bad. And I really actually like the kind of OG value this kind of throws to the Setme design. And I really love the wood furniture on these guys. They're a heck of a lot of fun to shoot as well. In fact, I've got a Setme mag right here. Let's just do it. Go ahead and chamber this guy up. And you'll see right here, I can throw this guy. I can lock it into place just like the MP5 clones over there. And yes, you can still do the slap on it. Let's go ahead and let's see that little nice burst of flame here. Oh, there we go. Let's try that again. Oh yes, that is sweet. All sorts of stuff flying down range there. Yeah, I don't know what was up with that first round. Probably just, I don't know, it's a brand new gun. I just lubed it up, so maybe it needs a little bit of a break-in. But anyway, well, I can't say brand new because these are built from Setme parts kits, but it still has, you know, some new parts to it as well. But really cool operation. I like it a lot. And I'll go ahead and grab my PTR here too. And also too, something that's pretty cool with the PTRs and the C308s are the fact that they can share mags. So we've got the Setme mags that'll work with it, but we've also, this is a newer G3 style mag that definitely works. Notice G3 right down here. That works in the C308 design and also the PTR-91 design. And we've got some surplus mags too. They are a little rough looking, but they're working well from the ones that I have tried. And you know, just spray a little ballast on them, clean them up, and maybe just make sure the followers look good and all. But they're at a heck of a good price. So if you're looking to go ahead and grab a bunch of surplus G3 mags for your PTR, C308, Setme, whatever you might have at home, do it. Anyway, let's take a look at this guy. Now you'll notice that this one's a little bit more tactical, right? So first off, yeah, I've got an optic on here, and I've also got a Midwest Industries M-Lock rail on it, vertical grip, bipod, because why the heck not, right? Now, of course, when you start doing that, that's gonna add some weight to it. This guy is significantly heavier than the C308, but granted, It's also got some different attachments to it. But let's go ahead, give a couple of shots with this guy, and yeah, why not? Oh man, that never gets old. Oh man, I absolutely love the operation of, again, that roller delay blowback system, and just it working in this big beefy configuration is just a heck of a lot of fun. So yeah, if you guys you got your PTR, I know you guys got plenty of PTR 91s out there. I want to hear your comments down below. Is it your favorite 7.62 calibered rifle? I don't know if it's my favorite, but it's up there, that's for sure. All right, let's take this guy back to the bench here. See if I can set it up without knocking down too much other stuff here. But anyway, whole lot of fun these roller guys are. And like I said, I think the Setme came around in the 1950s, and it also, the roller delayed action can be found in, you know, machine guns as early as like the MG42, a very similar setup. So it's just really cool that technology has been around for a long time, still in use today, and a heck of a lot of fun. Last gun we got here is a Setme L, which is pretty neat. So this guy right here is actually a 5.56 chambered Setme. So it's just a, it's a C308 that was, you know, left in the dryer a little too long. However, not Sentry. These guys are, I think it's Macklemore Firearms, there we go. Whew, that took a lot for me, guys. And a really neat little platform. This overall, really cool looking. 5.56 again, takes regular AR mags, which is really neat. It comes with a 130 round Dura mag, and just a really cool little gun. This guy here does not feature a locking mechanism here, so that's just one thing, and also to the rear sights on them. Let's go ahead and show that sight picture for you guys the best that I can. And it's something different, something that I would definitely have to get used to for sure. But, you know, I really don't mind it. Like I said, I'd have to just kind of take some more shots with it before I felt extremely comfortable with it. So it's, if it's something that you're looking for, that's just a really cool looking firearm, check out the Setme L by Macklemore. Yeah, there we go, I got it. Sorry if Macklemore, if you're watching and I completely butchered your name, my bad. But anyway, guys, let me know your thoughts and comments down in the comment section below, all about roller delayed goodness, because that is exactly what it is, a heck of a lot of fun. And we'll just show off this PTRK one more time, because yeah, these things are a heck of a lot of fun. All right. I think we'll leave it off there. The last gun I want to talk to you guys about is our current giveaway. This guy is our current giveaway. This is the Nemo Omen, chambered in 300 Win Mag, coming with the Trigicon 10mm scope, worn bipod on it, proof research barrel, Nemo's two chamber brake, which just makes this thing so flat shooting, adjustable gas system on it as well, which is really cool. The Magpul PRS stock, which has its adjustable length of pull and comb height, is just awesome, guys. And this thing is so much fun to shoot. You wouldn't think that a 300 Win Mag would have like no recoil. This one has like no recoil. All right, so Donut Operator, we're partnering up with him and giving one of these away as well. So he has his that he's been showing off. So you guys go check out Donut Operator and his YouTube channel. He does some pretty cool stuff there. And go check out Premier Body Armor too, because we partnered up with them on this as well. And so not only are you getting a signed skateboard from Donut Operator, but you're also getting some body armor from Premier Body Armor. So if you're looking for more information on that, head on over to classicfirearms.com, hit that top banner, and that's gonna take you to a webpage to show you all the different links to get your entries in, all right? So don't miss out on this guy. Again, I wanna hear from you guys down in the comments all about the roller delayed blowback goodness that we've got up here. Oh, that's beautiful. All right, I'm gonna leave it off there, guys. God bless you all, and we'll see you next time at classicfirearms.com.